This is a 2000 model F-150 with a 4.2 liter. I'm hoping you can hear the lopiness of the engine, and it's hard to tell if you're going to be able to hear it from this recording or not, but you can hear air sucking past the idle air control valve. But if you listen kind of closely and move your head around, you can also hear some sort of a vacuum noise back here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my handy dandy bottle of propane and run it back here where I know there is a fitting and see if it changes. See where that smoothed out? There's a vacuum elbow right there for the PCE valve on the back of the intake. We believe it's going to be sucking air, and this propane has found it very quickly. Lopiness is there, or it's coming back. And it's smoothed out and hit the right spot there. It must be sucking just a little bit. It's not a huge hole like a lot of them have. But I believe that's going to be the cause of this rough idle. It's going to take a little bit of digging around back there to get it out. I got to see if I can get my fat rear end in here and get back to this fitting or elbow or whatever it is without having to move too many things around. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Usually it's got a hard plastic line and a rubber elbow that goes out on these PCV valve hoses, but this looks like a piece of hose all the way through. That was interesting. But you see that hose right there? It wasn't tore that bad before, but you can see where it's got a depression right there. It's gotten soft and it's been sucking in, and it had a small hole here. So now I guess I just got to go find me a piece of hose that can match that up with, and this problem should be fixed. Okay, so this is a piece of molded hose. Of course, it's bad. You know, you can tell that it's gotten soft over the years and started sucking air. All I have is some rolled hose, so I'm gonna have to cut an extra long piece and put it in there and make a big loop back there so it doesn't collapse on itself, and hope I get enough of it right the first time, because I don't really want to try and drag this whole box full of stuff back there and try to get it right. Now I've got me a piece of hose about a foot and a half long. Now I'm going to see about getting it on there.
I don't know why I got the light back here. I can't see anyways. It's too much of an angle to go around stuff. All I can do is feel. Okay, there's the elbow, or the nipple. It's strange how we name so many car parts after body parts. Alright, that's on there. Now I got to figure out where the other piece is at. It's right there. So we need to see with it being there. I need to cut this hose right about there. So in other words, I only needed about half of what I got. That'll be interesting. I'll try and cut it back here in the hole now. Might have to just pull this back off. Let's see. I want to cut right about here. mark right there and see if I can cut it with my pliers. If not, I have to get snips or something to cut it. Make sure there's nothing else in there because this is sharp as bejeebies. And pretty much anything you can get in the jaws, it will cut. Okay, now, reach back here and get the hose. Work on bringing it around. Okay, I got that. It's in the area. I think. Yep. Let's see. Where is it at? You can halfway feel it. This one right here should be. And we got the elbow or Y fitting right back here. So that appears to be in there. Now I got to put the PCV valve back in the grommet and stick the other hose back on it. That ought to be something. So that should be on there, and that should be on there. That's on there, so we should be done. Can't butum this, but it's done. Let's see how it cranks up and runs. Well, with hearing all that, I can now hear this front one stuck in air. See that? Propane? No propane. Now I'm going to see about getting that one out of there. I don't know if you could, if you saw that or not, but there's a vacuum elbow right there that goes on the other end of the PCE valve hose, and it's sucking air. Let's see if I can get it off of there. And that's that end off. I have to go in from here to get the other end off, I think. I think I can bring it up through here. Yep. Get something to cut it. And just put a little cut along this side so I can split it and roll it off of there. Hopefully. And there's the other vacuum leak on the PCV valve hose. One in the back, one in the front. Got to go get an elbow rounded up. We can buy these in the aftermarket. Hopefully I'll put a link in the notes. Let's see if we can get really, yeah, that's a lot clearer there now. Got to go get one rounded up and put it on there and finish this thing up. Okay, I just got the new part in. Should be, can we see that anywhere? Yep, 46022.
New PCV valve elbow. It matches up to the old one, except it doesn't have a hole sucked in it. So it should be able to get that in and finish taking care of this. It looks a little bit tight. It's going to be fun getting that on there. Well, I'm running into a problem with this fine new part that I got. It's a little bit too tight to go on the hose. So what I'm doing is I'm sticking a pair of needle nose pliers in there and spreading it apart to hopefully open it up a little bit. Get it loosened up to where I can get it on there. A lot of times you would think you would just put some lubricant on there, but you got to be careful of that because it'll go through and possibly wipe out an oxygen sensor. And then most of the lubes will also affect the rubber. So now I got to figure out if I can get that all the way on there or not. I may have to put something on it to get it to slide. A little bit difficult, ain't it? I think I just ran out of rear end to be able to do it. And now, try to get the other end on there. That's going to be a trip, too. Okay, that's going to be interesting. So I got to hold that insert up and get the hose on at the same time. Doggone it. Let me try and get this off. Get over here and do something. At least get in the vicinity. Okay, that gets me right there to it. Now, I swear I've never seen the vacuum elbow have an insert in it for the PCV valve. You'd think the PCV valve would be the whole thing. I guess I'm gonna have to try and do the same thing I did on the other end to get the hose in there. Wallow it out some. Stretch it, you know? And this right here is why we like factory parts. You never had this problem if it was a genuine Ford part. At least I don't believe you would.
Come around this side and finish getting it pulled up. I guess that's the stop ring on there. Yep, that's the stop ring, so that's good. So now I should be able to put this back on there and get this thing fired up again. Now, let's see if we fire up and get some steady idle. It runs so much better, doesn't it? Well, there we have it. We had one leak on the front vacuum elbow for the PCV valve hose going under the bottom of the intake. And we had the hose that runs from the PCV valve Y tube up into the back of the intake. And we had a hole right there that I made bigger when taking it off, and then it was soft and squishing together. You can see the suction line there and the one there. Replaced it with the bout. Well, I got close to a foot left, so we probably replaced it with about a foot and a half, probably about a foot of
the vacuum hose 3/8. And I'm not sure if because the cam fuse is missing, it's KAM, keep alive memory fuse, it was missing, setting a code P1633. I'm not sure if that code being set and the fuse being missing prevented this thing from coding a P0171 and a P0174 for a lean condition, which should have been there with those hose pieces leaking. But regardless, I believe this thing's fixed. Sparky out.